Now, in building your brand too, there's social media, but of course, as you know, there's ups and downs, there's good decisions, and there's mistakes. And I'm sure you've had plenty of those stories over the years, but was there ever a client or a friend or even an employee of yours that went from nothing to having everything, or, you know, from zero to hero in a sense?
Yeah, I mean, listen, I mean, I more than I can count on. I mean, nowadays, so I mean, there's, you know, it, you know, there's back in the day when I invented the straight line, it was specifically designed to take people that were not natural one closers and enable them to close at the same level as natural born closers. Before the straight line system, you had this really large split between salespeople that, you know, that some could do the job. You had that 80-20 rule, essentially, like it vastly exaggerated at most companies, almost like the 90-10 rule, where 10% of the salesmen will bring in 90% of the revenue, the rest would struggle. And then when I invented the straight line, they began calling it the great equalizer, because it would essentially equalize any person with someone who's a natural born closer with a better education and a, you know, better pedigree, who's in a family. So it allowed you to compete at the same level with anybody else. And it was a huge breakthrough. One example that you probably are not familiar with, I talk about it in the book, but, you know, most people don't read books, they watch movies, and it didn't make it into the movie, was this guy, a very early case of a guy named Bobby Koch. And Bobby, you know, when I invented the straight line system, you know, the success was so rapid and so dramatic, it was shocking, right? And I had 12 people, and, you know, all 12 became million-dollar producers, you know, virtually overnight. It's not really true, it's an exaggeration, because one of them, it was 11 actually, it's just easy to tell the story as 12. There was one of them who could not do it. He like literally was so, he was, I have to say, he was so dumb, and he had such a thick guttural New York accent. It was like toxic sludge coming out of his mouth, right? And, you know, those first 12, 11 took off, and then I hired 100 more behind. And Bobby just struggled for like 6 months. And I actually went out and I hired a speech coach to help him drop his New York accent, to soften it. And he kept studying the straight line and learning the nuances. And it took about maybe 6 months in his case. And then he zoomed, and now, you know, he's making millions of dollars a year as a salesperson and became a top producer as well. This was a person that really was like the worst salesperson on the planet, and with a very limited, you know, intellectual capacity, right? But, you know, even then, you know, if you heard this guy on the phone talking to a person worth $100 million, you'd be like, damn, this kid's sharp, right? And it changed his life. But the gist of it, and I could dig it up if you want me to read it here for everybody, it's really interesting. He's probably 23 or 24 right now. And he's now the top producer at, I think, MetLife. It's a huge insurance company. And he trains other people. He's a regional. He's the number one producer in the company nationwide. He's won awards. He's got to be, I think, he's under 20, 24, 25 maybe, right? And he had a broken home. He failed out of school. He never amounted to anything. He was broke at 18. He had a drug, a whole thing. And then he started studying the straight line. And literally his rise by using the straight line, following the training I did, both mindset and skill set in sales, he started off his first year, became the top producer in the region, then the next year the top producer in the country, and then became the manager. And now this kid's like in his mid-20s, and he's mentoring other people, and he's wildly successful, and that's in the insurance field. I could tell you so many other cases of people in the solar field, you name it. And, you know, in fact, it's to me, I think that persuasion sales is a required skill for everyone. If you're not really proficient at that, you know, you can still make money, but you have to work three times as hard as everyone else around you can do.